LeBron Damian with it anywhere. You ever heard of that dude Swaggoo, aka Marcus Spitz? I can't find him either. Can't find the playmakers. Don't see no Emmitt Smith. Hell, last time I checked, I don't even know if that old Troy Aikman wanted to talk about these Cowboys. Real tough times. Real tough times. But I'm here to make the day better for you, okay? First day, up next. Don't miss it.
A fake punt. Snap it back to Thompson, and he runs a reverse. Coming right, Cedric Wilson, and he's going to lose yardage.
Oh, that was crazy.
Instead of punting the ball away, now from their own 24.
That was crazy.
And they didn't have 5 yards to go.
No.
They had 10 yards to go.
It was a solid play call. It's a good play design. Their gunner made a good play, came off of it. He put us in a high-low read. That's the nature of those plays. You can never convert them, obviously, if you don't call them and if you don't believe in them. So I clearly understood the situation when it was called.
Washington hands off to Antonio Gibson, who streaks down the sideline. Touchdown! An inside handoff. Gibson has the space at the 30, 25, into the free. 10, 5, touchdown!
Hey.
Touchdown, Washington! Yeah.
Well, well, well. Good morning, Max Kellerman. I'm Molly Karam Rose, and it looks like Southern Steve has made an appearance for some leftovers. All of us, I think, had an unusual subpar Thanksgiving, including the Cowboys. But, Mr. Smith, you seem to enjoy yourself. Huh? Let me ask you this, sir. Washington dominating Dallas. Go ahead. Go ahead, Southern Steve.
I just want to say howdy. How do? I hope, Molly, you and Max had a wonderful Thanksgiving, equitable to mine. Because I got to tell you something right now. It was special. It was very, very special.
Can't imagine why you're in such a great mood.
I'm glad somebody enjoyed themselves. Southern Steve, let me ask you this. Mike McCarthy, do you think he blew the game for your Dallas Cowboys down there in Texas?
Well, absolutely, positively correct, Molly. I mean, I don't think there's any way to deny that. Did you see that man coach that game yesterday, Max Kellerman? Did you see that man? Did you see him go for fourth and inches on his own 35-yard line in the first half, but not give the ball to Ezekiel Elliott and instead elect to pass the ball against the number one pass defense in the National Football League? That's the Washington Redskins. That's what I saw. Did you see him try a fake punt, okay, from his own 24-yard line of 4th and 10? Did you see that? That's what I saw. Did you see that play materialize and Mike McCarthy not recognize the fact that it might have been one of the worst calls we've seen in quite some time? This man actually sat up there with a straight face and said, you know something? It was a good call. You understand? It was right there to be executed correctly, okay? The bottom line is this man doesn't seem to know what he's doing too often. Now, obviously, we have to look at other players. We got to look at the Ezekiel Elliott of the world, rushing for only 32 yards on 10 carries. We got to look at him fumbling for the 6th time this year. Fumbled 5 times. Never had more than 5 fumbles. Already got 6 this season. He has clearly regressed. Did you see Andy Dalton throw that pick 6? Whole bunch of problems. But in the end, what it comes down to is that the game was right there. Right there. The Dallas Cowboys were only down 4. Only down 4. Even when Jalen Smith got the interception and got chased down by McLaurin and they had first and goal on their own 4-yard line, I thought Mike McCarthy knew something about offense. But you're in the red zone 3 or 4 times, can't get in. Can't get in the end zone. You combine them not being able to get into the end zone. Look at the fake punt. Look at going in for 4th and inches. Look at him throwing a football when he should have been running the football. I don't think there's any doubt in our minds that Mike McCarthy has been a liability, or at the very least, especially yesterday, he was more of a liability than an asset as head coach of those Dallas Cowboys.
Well, everything you said is right about Mike McCarthy, but it was coaching that cost Dallas the game, but it wasn't the Dallas coach. They didn't lose by a touchdown or even 2. They got curb stomped. And guess who's the coach on the other sideline? Because that's the coaching that we should be talking about today. Mike McCarthy's trying to be something he's not, right? Oh, I understand the analytics now. I have to go for it more, so he goes for it. Zone 24. Ridiculous, right? But they don't call Ron Rivera Riverboat Ron for nothing because he was doing that stuff before everyone was doing it. He and Belichick, a few others, right? That's why they call him Riverboat Ron, because he was willing to take risks. That's really who he was. But it wasn't at the expense of sound football. Rivera always has competent teams. Whether or not they always have winning seasons, so few coaches ever never have a losing season. But usually Carolina had winning seasons. A lot of times they were in the playoffs. They even made a run to the Super Bowl, right? Because they're soundly coached teams. Those guys are coached up. So when McLaurin goes and pulls a DK Metcalf, right, chasing down the defensive player who's streaking toward the end zone on what should be a pick six, when he makes a play like that, when you see that all over the field, guys doing that little bit of extra, it's because they're well coached. It's because they're motivated. It's because in a season that looked lost, right, with Alex Smith, who was going to retire, you know, everyone just assumed he was gone because he had taken such a beating, really. That guy is your quarterback. The season's lost, except it's not. And that's the mark of a really competent coach. By the way, Washington tried their own trick play. And now, he has a much better sense than McCarthy of when to do it. Ain't going to be from his own 24 on fourth down. But it's not like he wasn't pulling stuff like that, too. So all the focus today is going to be on McCarthy and his mistakes. They put up 40. They only gave up 16. And Ron Rivera has a lot to do with that.
Max Kellerman, I got to tell you something, buddy. You're a kind soul. And that's what this is about. You're being entirely kind to that Washington team that doesn't have football in it. And I know where you're going with this, Max Kellerman. I know where you're going with this. You want to tell me why? Want me to tell you why you're so kind? Because they're no longer the Redskins. A matter of fact, they've been so ashamed of themselves, they won't even give themselves a damn name. They're the Washington team. They won't even let us know whether they're from D.C. or the Pacific Northwest, let alone give themselves an actual name. They don't have a mascot. They don't have anything going on right now. So you're probably proud of them, and you're happy about them. And because of that, you want to give them a pass. I understand. I understand, Max Kellerman. I understand. But here's the reality of the situation. Brother. When you look at Alex Smith, Max Kellerman, he threw for 149 yards. Is that something to write about? No. 115 yards rushing on 20 carries by Antonio Gibson. It's a good day. No question about it. But is it knock your socks off like a Derrick Henry performance? No, it isn't. Okay? When you look at their offensive performance overall, ain't nothing to write home about. That defense is something special now. That defense is something special. We got to look out for them. But Montez Sweat and all of these brothers, I mean, we got to give respect where respect is due. But when you look at what Mike McCarthy did, talk about bringing Christmas to Dallas a month early. He was hanging out. He was handing out gifts all night long. The fourth and inches, the fake punt, the fumble by Ezekiel Elliott, Andy Dalton with a pick six. How about going for it in fourth and inches and not running the damn football when you got a $90 million running back, okay? But instead, choosing the pass. I gave you five things off the top of my head right there that shows that's about coaching. That was about the coaching on the Dallas Cowboys side, not the Washington football team. And as a result, Max, that's why we're sitting here today talking about these boys, because that's how pathetic they were. I feel sorry for the Cowboys as an organization. Jerry Jones didn't make the right call. Stephen Jones didn't make the right call. Mike McCarthy's not the man for that job. But I am very happy for what the Cowboy fan is going through this morning. They are so miserable right now. They're hiding from me, Max. I can't find them. Oh, by the way, Max, did you know that playmaker called me about an hour ago? He was hiding for 12 hours, but he called me about an hour ago, Max. And he sat up there and tried. And you know what he tried to do, Max Kellerman? That old playmaker, Michael Irvin? You know what he tried to do? He said COVID-19, the coronavirus pandemic, and the way it has ravaged this nation and this world, it is apropos that that has happened with the Cowboys. So he's trying to use it as an excuse and trying to hide beneath that to point out their ineptitude. That's how pathetic the Cowboy fans are. Floor is yours, buddy.
I can't argue with the points you're making about Mike McCarthy from yesterday. Your $90 million running back, give him the ball on 4th and 1. Duh. Try a quarterback sneak, maybe, right? That's the actually most efficient thing you can do in a short yardage situation. A quarterback sneak.
Yeah.
From a guy like who's done it before, a guy who came into the league as a pretty fast quarterback. Like, you know, there are a million things you can do, and Mike McCarthy did, and even him claiming, hey, if it works, it's good. I'm not going to second guess the negative outcome from your own 24. Of course, like, I can't argue against Mike McCarthy's bungling yesterday. But what's that got to do with Ron Rivera? And by the way, Stephen A., I understand what you mean, minority coaching.